Good morning, everyone. Just a minute, guys. I'm going to start. I'm just creating some space. So give me 1 minute. Couple of minutes, we're going to start. Just give me a minute. couple of minutes, guys. Let me just copy the data. My space is run out. Give me one couple of minutes. Okay, I'm back. It's copied my data. Sorry for 10 minute delays. Okay, so we are ready to go. Wonderful. So we talked about bless you. Good morning, Prashad. Good morning, Ravindra. Good morning, Vijay. Good morning, David. Good morning, Imran. Good morning, everyone. Okay. Good morning to the class. Good morning, Edwin. Okay, so we go back to our so then unit number 11 is middleware. So we're going to talk about 441, and in that also, in 441, we talked about, we discussed unit 11. This is our last unit. So CRM middleware, we talked about in the last class. Let me recap. So we talked about that CRM middleware is inherently part of SAP CRM server. So when you install SAP CRM, you also get CRM server along with it. And we discussed technical integration, that we talked about CRM middleware integrate with the backend. How does it integrate? We talked about this landscape, that in CRM server, you can connect CRM server to you know, backend ERP, to the backend third party, group where basically me calendar, you can integrate CRM server with the BI, with the mobile client. So you can use middleware to integrate SAP CRM to various SAP products like backend SAP ECC, APO, BI, or also you can use middleware for you know, integrating into non-SAP applications as well. We talked about CRM server architecture in the last class, in which we say in the CRM server, you have a CRM database, and you have a different applications, and then in the different application, you have a different adapters. These adapters are there in SAP CRM, and these adapters are basically are part of various objects which you can have in SAP CRM. You can have adapter for R3, adapter for BW, adapter for external interfaces, adapter for group where you have a different adapters which are possible, which SAP FICO, SAP CRM architecture has. You can have all these different architecture as a part of it. And then we talked about in the CRM architecture, we talked about CRM database. In the CRM application, you can have different objects. You can transfer different data. We talked about the transfer of the data happens using business docs or business document. Business docs or business documents are used to exchange the data. with SAP and the backend application. That is where the BDoc comes into the picture. And that is where the BDoc are being used to transmit the data. So BDoc is the container. BDoc is the object which is being used to transfer the data between SAP and different non-SAP applications. That is the method which is being used. Okay. So BDoc. BDocs are the data canvas. We talked about in the last class, BDoc or business objects is the one which is used to carry the data from one system to another system. We talked about the BDoc is the data carrier, and we talked about in the BDoc, if you're going to see the BDoc also, BDoc is basically is a container, is a carrier of the data. When the data is being transmitted from SAP to other applications, how the data get transmitted? The data get transmitted using BDocs, and these BDocs are the data carriers. In the BDoc, what happens is you can combine different tables, like you see KNBB, ADRC, and KNBA. These are the different tables which is combined together, and you can send the data, entire data together into one table. So this is the BDoc structure. So for example, if you're sending your business document for a customer master, you have the list of KNA1, ADRC, KNBB. So KNA1 is a sales order general data table, ADRC contains that address, and KNBB has a shipping sales data, and all the three tables together goes into the carry the data into one BDoc. And that is where the BDoc is helpful, because you can use BDoc to transfer the entire data in one bucket. And there are different BDoc types which are there in the standard SAP. These BDoc types can be used. These BDoc type classify what kind of BDoc it is. This is inbound and outbound processing that also we talked about in the last class, in which so let's say this is my CRM database. From the CRM database, let's say I'm creating a sales order, let's say I'm creating a product master, let's say I'm creating any other application or any other data record. That data record goes to the database. And when this goes to the database, it creates a BDoc, MBDoc. MBDoc basically means message in BDoc. Then that is read by something called admin console. We're going to see what is admin console is. So there is an SAP business one, in SAP CRM, there is something called admin console. Now, if you come back here, if I go to CRM menu, if I go to architecture technology administration, and here we have admin console. So this is the menu path for admin console. So make a note of this menu path. So this is the menu path for the admin console. Now admin console basically allow you to the transfer the data. If the data is going out of SAP, wherever the data goes out, that is defined so that is where admin console is. We're going to go there. What does the admin console do? Good morning, Saeed. How are you, buddy? So that is admin console. Then, if the data coming into SAP, so that is data coming into queue, that is called inbound queue. Data going out, that goes to outbound queue. Go to R3 adapter, write into it, do the validation, post into CRM. Data going out, it's in CRM backend, create MBDoc. Go to admin console. Admin console reads it, send it to outbound queue, and in the queue, then whatever the system it is supposed to, that system reads it. And you can have inbound queue, and you can have outbound queue in the system. Both are possible in SAP to have inbound queue and also having outbound queue. Admin console determine who is the recipient. We talked about that before. Take care, Sahid. So we have inbound queue and we also have a outbound queue. So we can define both. That is what we have discussed. We talked about. Now coming back to the data exchange between SAP CRM and SAP ERP. So how the data exchange takes place? So some of the configuration, some of the setting, some of the elements we will talk about. We will discuss so how some of these configuration elements and some of these elements works. So now look at this picture. This picture is there in admin console. Now look, in this picture 145, it describes something interesting and important. If the data is going out of CRM to a system, for example, ERP system, there is something called admin console. If the data going out, there is the admin console. Okay, there is admin console. Okay. Okay. So here. We can have a admin console if the data going out. And then if data coming in, then we have something called object management. So two different things. Two different things. In the first, we have a object management. If data is coming in object, so if data is coming in the SAP CRM, then you have object management. If data going out, then we have admin console. These are the two different elements. They have two different configurations. So this is admin console. And then this is object management. Make a note of the both menu paths. So one is the menu path for object management. And then second one, is for admin console. So these are the two different menu paths. Okay. Admin console, object manager. If data going out, outbound, you need admin console. If data coming in, inbound, then you need object management. That is what we have seen here. Data coming in, data going out. Okay. Now this is the menu path where you have menu path, architecture, technology, middleware, data exchange, initial load, start. How do we do initial load? So make a note of this menu path also. This is the menu path for initial load. Okay. So we have an initial load, start. And this is the transaction code for admin console. Now initial load is start, where it is. This is initial load is start. Transaction code R3AS. R3AS is the transaction code for initially downloading the data. For initially downloading the data. Okay. So this is R3S. Admin console, object management, initial load, R3S. That is what we have admin control. SMC. Backend integration support object. What kind of object you can transfer? So now look at this figure 146 carefully. So customizing objects can come from ECC to backend. So like conditions, like pricing record, pricing procedure, condition table, access sequence. So all those different customizing objects you can transfer from ECC to CRM, but not other way around. Billing information you can transfer from the CRM to the ECC, not other way around. Business partners you can copy on both sides. So business partners you can copy from ECC to CRM, from CRM to, so they see the arrow is in bi-directional. This arrow is only one direction. This inbound, this is outbound, this is both directions. You can define data definition as per your choice. What data can come in and what data can go out. So you have a choice. So, Okay. In the backend, you can transfer three type of data: condition object, business object, condition object, customizing object. Three categories of the data can be transferred. If we see here, business object, customizing object, condition object. So business object, customizing object, condition object. So these three categories of the data can be copied within the system. From backend system to the frontend system, you can copy these three categories of the data. Okay. So business object, customizing object, and condition object. Which you can do in SAP system. Okay, so we can object management, and then we have something called initial load. So we have object management, initial load. Now look at here. So CRM database, ECC database, on the CRM, we have something called R3 adapter, and in the ERP, we have a plugin. But adapter and plugins are two programs. These are the two programs which are having a dialogue with each other. And with using object management, I'm going to show you object management. You can transfer the customizing data, business object data from the system. Okay. In the object management, you can define the filter. We're going to see that in the configuration as well. Filter criteria. Filter criteria basically means that what kind of a data we can load, and the what kind of data we cannot load. Okay. We can talk about how can we load data. So here we can define different filter parameters. Using different filter parameter, we can define which data can be transferred and which data cannot be transferred. We can do that. That is possible. Transferring the data. Filter criteria. I will be showing you that. This is the start initial load. If I have to do initial load, then how do we do initial load? This is the initial load. Okay. This is the initial load. We can define okay. R3S. So this is here, data initial load and download. Okay. There is something called monitoring cockpit. So there is something called monitoring cockpit. This is monitoring cockpit. Monitoring cockpit allow us to monitor various objects. That is what is called monitoring cockpit. In the monitoring cockpit, we can monitor different kind of objects. That is where the monitoring cockpit comes into the picture. Monitoring cockpit. In admin console, there is something called replication. There is something called replication. admin console. In the admin console, we have something called replication model. So we replication and publication. Two things. Replication and publication. Replication basically means the data which can be replicated by the system and published to go to other clients in other system. I will show you that as well. Okay. So just give me 1 minute or let me bring some water and I will do some exercises. Just 1 minute. Okay, I'm back. So first and foremost, I go to admin console. So this is admin console. I go to this is a transaction code, admin console. Okay. So if you go back here, these are the different sites. So that basically means R3. So because R3 has been defined in admin console, therefore, we can send the data to R3. Okay. So here we, if we double click on this R3, okay. So we see here, we have 19 subscriptions. That basically means this is assigned to 19 different objects. Now, if I double click here, we have a site attribute. These are the RFC connection, logical destination. Which defines logical linking between the systems. So that is how admin console works. Back. Back. And here we have a object management. In the object management, you can define different objects, three category of object: business object, customizing object, condition object. If I go to business object, here we have all different objects which you can define. These are all different objects. So let us say I want to maintain the customer master. Okay. If I could double click on it, now here, if I want to define different filters, I can define different filters. This is a table. If I select my sales org, equals to 1000. So that basically means take all customers who are and that basically means that I'm going to take all customers which are in okay. You can define the filter. This feature is really cool. Yes. And you can define on the basis of different parameters. Back. No. This is the monitoring object. Here you can see how many sites are defined. The doc status, system setting, and these are the total object which has been transferred. These are different object names. Okay, so we're gonna take 10 minutes break and we talk in 10 minutes. Okay, I'm back now. Let us begin. So now, so what we discussed is about admin console, object management, and then we talk about monitoring cockpit, monitoring cockpit. Then I will talk about the next element, which is initial load. Initial load is R3S. Okay, now here we can put an object if you want. So let's say you want to upload the material master. So that is how initial load works. You put your material, or any load object. You can choose any object as you want. There are so many objects. So we go back here, so we have so many objects here. And then you can execute, and then we will be able to upload any record. So that is how this works. So this way you can actually load okay. Now we go to the next topic, monitoring and data exchange. So when you monitor the data from CRM to R3 or ECC, there is something called a data integrity manager and the request. So here we have a data integrity manager or the data request. So from CRM to ECC, ECC to CRM, there is something called data integrity manager. Now, what does this basically mean? Okay. So, data integrity manager. Data transferring from ECC to CRM, CRM to ECC. If you go back, you have a data exchange for monitoring object. And here we have a SMW01. There's a different inbound and outbound queue. So this is inbound queue, outbound queue, SMQ01, SMQ02. These are some of the important transactions. And for the workload and for performance, you can see different workload parameters. Data integrity manager basically tells if to target and system, a target and source system, if the data is constant or is there any problem. So you can see, you know, the data from both perspectives. So you can define that. Okay, the data integrity manager. In the monitoring cockpit, we have a SMWP. This is a monitoring cockpit. You have a different other transaction, SMQ1, SMQ2, and all these different transactions exist here in this menu part. And you can check all these different pieces. Okay. Some of these transactions are important. Monitoring cockpit, important. I mean, everything is important, but these probably are more important. So these are some of the important okay. Make a note of these transaction codes. So we can go to these transition codes, please. This is a transition code that is called SMW01. We're going to run this transition code, which is basically processing the IDOC and then sweeping all those different IDOC. It's important. And we're going to see. So we can do SMW01, we're gonna go there. Error analysis, there is also some table, VDOC track. In this table, you can see if how many IDOC has failed, what is the status of these IDOC. Okay. I want to do an exercise. VDOC monitoring. How do we monitor the VDOC? So for the VDOC monitoring, this is the transaction code. Which is here, SMW01. So make a note of this transition code. If I go to SMW01, I can run these IDOC by different parameters, inbound, outbound. Make a note of this menu path. Okay. Okay. So if I put my user, Dilip is my user ID. These are the different VDOCs in different status. And these are the dates. January 8, 2019, January, December, and the different dates. These are the different VDOC which has been created. Most of them are green. Some of them are red. If there is anything red, that basically means that VDOC has failed. Anything which is in green, that basically means that is successfully transmitted. So here, these are all business, these are all VDOCs. So this is business transaction message VDOC, run on this date. This is VDOC type. This is MVDOC on this date, on this time. This is the queue number by this user. If I go all the way, this is VDOC ID. Every VDOC has a unique ID. This is VDOC ID. So now what to do with this VDOC? How do we process VDOC? How do we execute this VDOC? If I go back here, you can show the VDOC message. You can reprocess VDOC. You can mark the VDOC deleted. You can do all that. And if I click on it, in this VDOC, this is a structure. So here we have a header, activity, org main, status, partner. All that information is there in it. All that information exists in this partner. In this VDOC, these are all structures which are available. So here, if I go back in the header, I see this value, and this is the information which I have here. Now in this structure, in the header, there is one entry. This is the task. This is the transaction 1097. This was the follow-up task which we created. So that activity which we created appears here. This was the this was the customer. This was the date, January 8, 2019. This was the description of that transaction. If I go back, this is a message activity. If I see the messages, if I go here, these are the different messages. This is the ID. This is the category. This is the priority. If how much this activity has been completed. So all that is there in the system. And then we're back. Then here we have a augment data. Select that. This is our, this is the whole augment data here. This was my organized structure, my sales office, my sales group, my person responsible for my service organization. Now this is coming from business partner data automatically. Now that is how you can do VDOC structure. And you can share everything in the VDOC. So this was the last unit. This was last unit. Next steps. So in the next step, I'm going to provide few videos, and one of them is on shipping topic. So there is a shipping topic, and I will provide few videos for that because that is one of the topics we need to do. So that is one of the topic we will be doing. And after that topic, you can rejoin next batch. Mock interviews. You can send your homework and I can review. Resume preparation. And marketing, and we can market it. Market is pretty good. So we can market you as soon as you want. So these are the next step so far. Okay. Next week, I don't know, probably very recently we're going to start. Next week, we'll start very soon. We'll let you know probably next week, following week, I don't know. So very soon, now we'll start the next batch. You're welcome, or anybody's welcome to start the class. So I will provide a few top videos for shipping topic and a few other videos. So a few other videos I will still provide for you to go through. And then you can rejoin the next course and you can do mock interview. And any other question anybody has? Otherwise, we'll talk to you possibly next week. So, no class tomorrow. And we will invite you all for next batch. When the next batch will happen, we will invite you for the next batch. Okay. Any questions, concerns? Thank you, everyone. Talk to you next week. Thank you, guys. Thank you.